you come out of that bookshelf. Jesus came out of Nazareth. You come out of that bookshelf where there are all kinds of books. People everywhere, when they look at you, will look also for your bookshelf.
Yep.
They're going to say that this is where you come from.
Amen.
On that bookshelf, you've got some criminals in your family. Their books are on your shelf because that's where you have been placed. On your shelf, also, you have some illiterate folks. These people cannot make a verb and a noun agree no matter what they do. And every other word in their sentences are an explicit, meaning it's vulgar.
Amen.
Also on your shelf are people who are unsavory characters. The world knows them as tricksters, or perhaps even as gangsters. They don't have the favor of the world, and they are not looked upon as people that you really want to be around. You're not in a hurry to have your kids be around these kinds of people because of their character and their attitude. Yet they are on your bookshelf. They are a book on your bookshelf. You didn't put them there, but they are there, and you are associated with them because you are a book on that bookshelf. And now someone is saying, but I know Bishop Ballard. He comes from that family. Oh, so that means he is filthy rich. And that means that he knows all about computers and electronics. And that means that they go on vacations all over the world. I know him. He's a book on this shelf. And this is what goes on this shelf. These people, these books, they do these things, so he must do those things too. Well, that was the upside. Someone else looks at the same shelf, and they don't know all the people on this shelf. They don't know all the books on this shelf, but the ones that they know causes them to have this kind of response. They go, oh, I know Bishop Ballard. Hey, wasn't his uncle the one that helped plan the bombing of the Twin Towers? Hey, isn't his family the one that had the association with the Taliban? Hey, isn't his family the one that has all of those mafia connections? Oh, well, in that case, we know what he's like. It can't be anything good there. This is the type of situation Jesus found himself in. Nathaniel wasn't trying to be necessarily offensive. He was speaking of the knowledge of the books that was on the shelf where Philip said Jesus was. And so immediately he says, well, based upon what I know, then can anything good come out of Nazareth? You want to go and apply for a job. You walk in and there's someone sitting at the desk. Uh-huh. And we're going to call it a receptionist, male or female. And they see you when you come in. Uh-huh. As you approach them, you let them know that you're there to apply for an opening. They haven't looked up at you yet. They are busying themselves with their receptionist secretarial type things. Uh-huh. But when they do look up, they see that you are a woman standing there. And they look at you and they tell you that we don't have any job openings. And you want to turn around and walk back out. But something inside of you says, wait a minute. I know what I read, and I know that I'm in the right place. And it says that they have openings for people to drive forklifts. And I can learn to drive a forklift. I just need the opportunity.
That's right.
So you turn around and you say, oh, but isn't this so-and-so company? Well, yes, it is. And your ad in the paper today, you pull it out, poof, says that you have openings and that you're hiring, and it just came out today. Well, yes, ma'am, it does. But we're looking for men, and we can't hire women to do this job. The assumption here is the shelf that you belong to have women on it, and you are just another woman. In this person's mind and assessment, you are not capable of doing the job. It's not their responsibility to refuse you a job application because of your gender. But that doesn't mean out of ignorance some people might actually do that. So this individual has filtered you out as not being capable of doing the job. That there's no way. This is a woman. I have my own ideology of women. I know 10, 15 women, and I have already assessed this person with them. And they couldn't do the job, so neither can this individual. This is Nathaniel's approach. He has simply said here now, he comes from Nazareth. Can any good thing come from Nazareth? He is not capable of being the Messiah, the prophet. All the books say he cannot do this. And therefore, that is my conclusion, even though I don't know him. The conclusion here is, even without filling out the application, you are inadequate for the job. You're on the shelf with all of these others, and you have been evaluated according to them. another scenario. You come in and they look at you, and this is a all black business. All black. Everybody that works for this company is black. And you are as white as snow. But you know that you can do the job. But you come in and you fill out the application. And then when you check back for the job, they simply tell you that they have filled the job. Mm-hmm. That there's no opening. Mm-hmm. As soon as you hang up the phone, there's a knock at your door. Your friend comes in. He's all excited. He says, guess what? I got a job. And you get excited with him because you all have been without a job for some time. Mm-hmm. And he says to you, guess what? I got a job at XYZ company. And you freeze. Because you want to know, how did you get a job at XYZ company when they told me that the job openings, that they were all filled? And he says, I don't know. I just filled out the application and they told me right there on the spot that I had the job.
Wow.
And I start tomorrow. You're despondent. You don't know what to do. You do everything within yourself to rise up and be encouraging to your friend. But there's something gnawing on you on the inside, and you can't quite find the words for it. But you know that something is wrong. Mm-hmm. A few days later, your friend comes back, and he's talking about his job. What he doesn't know is that you applied there also. And he begins talking about the talk. He says, you know, the fellas there say that we don't hire white folks, but we can't tell them. And they were chuckling because they said, about a week ago, some white guy came in and he filled out the application. And everything looked good, but he was white. So we didn't hire him. Now you have a problem because you've been rejected because of somebody else's biases. Mm-hmm. They have put you on a shelf.
Yep.
They have taken you the book and put you on the shelf with all of these other books that they know about, and they have determined that you are just like these books. They haven't opened you up. They don't know what's on the inside. In fact, they're not even interested. All they know is they see what you look like on the outside, and they have classified you with what they know from others that they've seen on the outside. Mm-hmm. Nathaniel has done the same thing to Jesus. He has simply said he can't do the job. He can't. He's from Nazareth. My gosh, what's the problem with you? Mm-hmm. Philip? And Philip said unto him, well, come and see. In other words, now somebody somewhere along the way has got to stop looking at the book as though it's speaking, and they've got to stop looking at the shelf that the book is on. Uh-huh. And letting the shelf speak for the book.